the legend that is Mike Sexton.
Well, I'm an old school poker guy, so I always like the old guys, but I'll tell you, the young guys are very tough players. They're really terrific players. They're very smart guys, and, you know, it's good that they're coming into the poker world, but, you know, maybe it's good I'm sort of heading out, maybe, huh? I think it helps me to, you know, having watched all these great guys play so many times on the World Poker Tour, that I do feel like I'm a better player now, even though I don't get to play very much anymore. But, you know, I do think it's helped for sure. Amazing. There's at least six guys at my table. Nobody at my table is over 28 years old except for me. And to me, maybe I'm just too old school or something, but I thought it was very common practice. And they say, would you ever say it on television? I say, well, actually, I do say it on television. But the problem is the hands that make the World Poker Tour show all have a flop and there's action to them. So nobody ever sees the action like that before the flop, so it never makes the air. Well, they couldn't have learned that term.
Well, Bingo Bango Bongo was very famous for a while there, and you can only slide so far on barbed wire.
Well, I've always considered myself a player first and a commentator second. Maybe I shouldn't think that way anymore, but that's the way I do think. And certainly when I have an opportunity to play now, like at the World Series of Poker, it's really fun for me to play because, you know, I don't get a chance to play very much anymore. And when I do, I really like the challenge of sitting down and playing against the best players. And I like to compete. And certainly competing at the World Series of Poker, you know, it doesn't get much better than that in the poker world. You know, to be the best, you got to beat the best. So, you know, I don't fault those guys for their strategy. They just haven't taken as many beats as us old guys, that's all. Once they realize they can get outdrawn once in a while, maybe they'll save one of them red buttons. I was there for all of it. They're all true stories in the book. And, you know, I'm one of the guys that people said, you should write a book. You should write a book because you have all the stories about the old guys who some of the legends are dying off, as we know. But I was there back in the 70s when I first came to town. I got to hang around all these great poker players. And because of that, I have a link to them that others don't have. And, you know, people have been encouraging me to write a book. You should do it with the stories and blah, blah, blah. So it was on the shelf for about, you know, 3 years ago. But then this past year, I really bored down and got it done, and very proud of it. And I think it's just a fun book, and everybody's going to like it.
Oh, it's phenomenal. The last two nights have been two of the greatest of my life, really. It's 2 days ago, we had a roast and a toast. It was more roasting than toasting for me to celebrate my 15 years with the World Poker Tour. And then last night, I was inducted into the WPT Honors, which is the highest prestige award you can get on the World Poker Tour. So it's been phenomenal, and I'm just so grateful and blessed and very appreciative to be included in that WPT Honors program.
I've started PokerGives.org with Linda Johnson, Jan Fisher, and Lisa Tenner, and we're trying to unite the poker industry to donate money as an industry.
You know, poker's good, and it's good for party poker, and, you know, everything's good.
Oh, please, that's sad for me. I'm a big Buckeye fan.
I know.
And 2 years in a row, it's just like a dagger in my heart there. So, sad day for the Buckeyes, but we're going to be back. Don't worry, we'll be back again.
All right, well, tell me.